For the last 7 years, it's been not only my honor, but also my duty to speak out for the dignity of every human being who shares this space. And for the last 2 years, it's very clear that there has been a big shift, that voices of anger and bitterness and hatred and intolerance are growing louder and louder and louder. And I ask myself every single day, what do we do about that? What is our response as a community to ensure that we maintain this place? For 7 years, I've said the promise of this place is that it doesn't matter what you look like or where you come from or how you worship or whom you love, that you're here, that's what matters, that you belong here, and that you have the opportunity to live a great life. So what do we do about stuff like this? Number one is we use our platform and our podium. Politicians need, every single time they talk to the community, to talk about the dignity of every single human being in the community. It's not a nice to have. It's essential to what we do every single day. And there are too many politicians who are flirting with the small-minded, the intolerant, the bigoted, the hating for short-term political gain. And we got to stand up to that, and we got to call that out. Now, specifically, what do we do about these marches? Well, you got to keep people safe, number one. You got to understand that people have charter rights, but in this country, those charter rights are also circumvented by hate speech provisions. And we have to be able to work together to make sure that happens. You know, sometimes the right answer is to ignore it. Let it fizzle out. Sometimes the right answer is to counter-protest and, you know, love and courage, as Jagmeet Singh says, right? Smother them in love and courage. But it's also a matter of being thoughtful as citizens about what it is we're trying to build together.